it sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, you've sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, you are singing over me. The Father's song, heaven's perfect mystery, the King of love has sent for me, and now you're singing. Listen to a thousand songs, but there is one that sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, you sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, you are singing over me. The Father's song, heaven's perfect mystery, love has sent for me, and now you're singing over me. The Father's song. Thank you.
the light of Christ, we welcome you as we wait in hope and pray for the ending of all violence and bloodshed. May the peace of Christ burn in our hearts and dawn on our world. Jesus said, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid." So this morning we gather remotely to remember the fallen, to dedicate our lives to God, and to our commitment to work for peace. We look back in sorrow for all those who have suffered injury and loss. We recall those who are suffering in conflicts in our world today. And we look forward to that day when the kingdoms of this world will be ordered by God's peaceable reign. We pray that all will be moved to remember the fallen and commit to peace. So let us pray. Almighty Father, whose will is to restore all things, in your beloved Son, the King of all, govern the hearts and minds of those in authority, and bring the families of the nations, divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin, to be subject to his just and gentle rule, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. As we look upon the wastes and sorrows of past and current conflicts, so we pray that the Lord will show us his mercy and his forgiveness and extend his healing upon our broken world. And so we pray for the coming of God's kingdom in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. So invite us to sing wherever we are and join in our praise as we sing, "Praise my soul, the King of Heaven."
Ransom healed, restored for.
to our act of remembrance. Let us remember before God and commend to his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of humankind.
They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them. We will remember them. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so together we sing again. O God, our help in ages past. Isn't it today? Yes. So. You've been having a nice week. Yeah, why have you had a nice week then, Bear? You've had a nice week because I've been busy. Yeah, I have been very, very busy. You're right. But because I've been busy, it meant that you've been able to play with Reggie and with Toffee. Oh, yes, and of course, Albie as well. We've got Albie staying, haven't we? It's a bit like a doggy daycare at the moment. I think they're just trying to talk to us as well, aren't they, while we're trying to film. Yeah. So what have you been playing? You've been playing ball. Yeah, super. And you've been having treats, been hidden around the house, have you? Yes, has that been good fun? Super. You've just been listening to me. So yes, that act of remembrance. Yeah, it was good, wasn't it? Yeah. It's very special though, isn't it? It's something special that we have to do, that we like to do, isn't it? Yeah. Yes, I'm sure it's okay. Yeah, you remembered all your doggy friends, haven't you? Your doggy friends that have passed away as well. Yeah, it's okay to remember your doggy friends. I think Reggie and Albie and Toffee are remembering theirs as well right now, aren't they? They're barking away. Goodness me, what are they like? So, we've got some birthdays this week, Bear. Okay, so we're not going to have a talk this morning. You can listen to the talk that's for everybody, okay? But we have got some birthdays. Whose birthday is it? Yes, well, today is Abigail's birthday, so happy birthday, Abigail. And later in the week, it's John's birthday. So happy birthday to Abigail and to John. And if it's your birthday and I've not mentioned your name, we wish you a very happy birthday too. So shall we sing happy birthday? remembering to mention Abigail and John. I'm going to hear a traditional and well-known poem read by Shirley. Thank you, Shirley.
In Flanders fields, the poppies blow between the crosses, row on row that mark our place. And in the sky, the larks, still singing bravely, fly scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders fields. Take up our quarrel with the foe, to you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders fields.
So let us sing together, Abide With Me. To chocolate, and I do lots of talks around chocolate, but today I'm shifting slightly, and instead my talk is going to be revolving around jelly babies. I'm sure lots of you like eating jelly babies. They're delicious, aren't they? And I had a funny story once about a jelly baby. When I was on hockey tour when I was at school, we went over to Ireland to play some other schools over in Ireland. And on the bus there, we were eating jelly babies. And I got the giggles, surprisingly. And behold, before you know it, the jelly baby that I popped in my mouth came back down my nose. It was crazy. I remember the feeling to this day. It was not pleasant. So why have I got a packet of jelly babies? And why have I told you that silly story? I don't know. Anyway, so the jelly babies have different flavours, don't they? Can you remember what the flavours are? That's right, there's strawberry, there's lime, there's lemon, there's raspberry, and there's orange. And there's blackcurrant, I've just been reminded. Absolutely. So which is your favourite? I think my favourite has got to be the lime. I tend to like lime, sort of citrus flavour sweets. So definitely for me, it's the green, the yellow, and the orange. Definitely. Now, jelly babies were first launched in 1918. And they were launched to celebrate the end of the First World War. But they weren't called jelly babies then. They were called peace babies. And they really became very, very popular. During the Second World War, production ceased because of a shortage of ingredients. So peace babies, they disappeared for a little while. But they were reborn in 1953. And that's when they were renamed jelly babies. And they're like as they are today, like what we've got that we can buy in the shops. So why have I decided to talk about jelly babies today? Well, it was a celebration in 1953 when jelly babies were launched, and it was a good way to celebrate. And I think it was a good way to celebrate because the peace babies marked a new beginning. They were babies, a new beginning, new life. And they showed that life was beginning to return to normal, or as normal as it could be. And that again, life could be fun. In 1989, each of the six jelly babies, peace babies, they were each given a name and given an identity. I don't know whether you've seen on the packet where they show you on the back of the packet here, the different colours and the names of each of the jelly babies. So I've got an open packet here, and so we have first of all our pink jelly baby, and our pink jelly baby is called Baby Bonnie. She's a baby, wears a nappy and has a frilly bonnet, and she's always crawling into mischief. Now, if we were in church, what do you think I'd be doing with these right now? You're right, I'd be throwing them around, wouldn't I? Throwing them out to each of you to try and catch and eat. But I can't do that from here. So that's our pink baby Bonnie. Then we have our green, our lovely green jelly baby. This one is called Boofles. Now, Boofles is soft-hearted and cries a lot. Even when he's happy, he cries. And if you have a look at him closely, he's got his hand up to his eye, wiping away the tears. Next we have Bumper. Now Bumper is orange. Here he is, orange Bumper. And Bumper wears a bum bag. So he's got a little bum bag across his tummy. And he bumps into things. So he's called Bumper. He's our orange jelly baby. And now on to our yellow. Our yellow jelly baby is called Bubbles. She's got hair and a ponytail, and she's bright yellow. She's like a ray of sunshine. Isn't she lovely? She tastes good too. Then we've got our black jelly baby, known as Big Heart. Now, Big Heart always puts his friends first. He's a lovely, faithful, friendly character, very selfless. What a lovely guy. And then finally we have our leader of the gang. And this is brilliant. And brilliant is the red leader of the pack. He is the one who's in charge of them all. So they were called peace babies. So what does peace actually mean? And why do we want to live in peace? Well, peace is enjoyed when people of different ages, with different interests and different appearances, all live together in harmony. A bit like inside this bag of jelly babies, all living together. And when we think about living in peace, some of us will automatically think, I've had too much peace, being isolated and being on my own. It's just too much. But remember and think perhaps of what we're doing during COVID-19 and during this new lockdown, that what we're doing is enabling others to have peace. We're enabling the NHS to survive and for people to be treated effectively and efficiently. So if you think and start to moan or to do things that show on Facebook or in conversations about whether this is a conspiracy or it's not fair or we should be allowed to do what we want and not do as we're told, then just think again. Just think again at bringing peace into our communities, peace into each other's lives, because we will be able to meet again. We will be able to see each other again. But just remember that those that lost their lives in the war, they won't be seen again. Those who lose their lives to COVID won't be seen again. So while each of us do our bit and bring peace into this place, then that's what we must do. Then there's a sense that each of us, each one of us, can be called a peace baby. So how can we work for peace? As I've already explained what we can do during the COVID crisis. But we can also try listening and learning from each other instead of arguing with each other. Perhaps we can count to 10 before we respond. Perhaps we can find out different ways of living, different ways of helping each other during this time. Working for peace doesn't mean being soft and squidgy like a jelly baby. It calls for a strong commitment to friendships, to fairness, to being ready to share, and for celebrating the good things, even though they might seem so small at the moment. It's important we stand up for what we believe, but it's also important that we live in peace and with peace in our hearts. I'm going to enjoy some jelly babies soon. I wonder how many of you are going to pop to the shop and buy the essential jelly babies. So let us pray. Loving God, help us to work for peace and to pray for peace, believing that all people are your children. Amen. Amen. So we're going to sing again. Put peace into each other's hands. Time of prayer as we pray for the world around us. We begin by praying a prayer using our coronavirus bookmark. God of healing and of hope, in Jesus you meet us in our places of pain and fear. Look with mercy on those who have contracted the virus, on any who are vulnerable, and on all who feel in danger. Through this time of global concern, by your Holy Spirit, bring out the best, not the worst, in us. Make us more aware of our interdependence on each other and of the strength that comes from being one body in you. Through Christ, our wounded healer, we pray. Amen. On this day, we hold with gratitude the service of those who are peacemakers in their service of our country. We're grateful for a vision that will hold the darker forces of our humanity in check. With an ethos of cooperation, harmony and mutual flourishing. We pray for the dedicated service for our armed forces in all the generations. Remembering especially those who still remain with us from the Second World War. We thank you for their testimony, which reminds us of the tragedy of conflict. Help us to hear it even as we honour the sacrifices made in search of the good. On this day, when we're drawn together from many backgrounds and with faith flickering, strong or with no faith, we thank you that there are times and causes around which we can all rally for the common good. Help us to find that common ground more and to work through our differences. May the example of Jesus, his boundary crossing life, his open-hearted embrace of all peoples, be the inspiration for our weary and wounded world. In the visions of Isaiah and Revelation, your faithful people have penned the dreams and challenges of our deepest thinkers, our most creative and perceptive voices. So we give thanks for the people who will look at our world and will be the dreamers. We pray too for the fixers, for the people who will take the dreams and make them reality. So we hold before you all of our leaders, praying for tenacity, energy and an open-eyed, open-hearted vision for our communities and for the world. On this day of remembrance, we pray for those who have lost loved ones in conflict through the collateral damage of war. We think of those close to home in our army, our navy and our air force. We remember those on the other side to us in conflict. And we think of the deep scars of conflict that mark our world whenever there is war. May our remembering be for new beginnings, so that lives lost are the foundations of new worlds. May the vision of the prophets be our vision too. May your forgiveness be our forgiveness. God of the cross and of the empty tomb, God of the road to Emmaus and the breakfast on the shore, you have shown us in Jesus the way that is beyond death. So hold us in the faith of your future. Help us to rest in the confidence of new light and life, to trust that those we have loved and lost have returned to you, and that our own walk is the way home, where you wait for us in the mystery of eternal life. May our prayers rise to you like incense. God, our Maker, our Saviour, and our Sustainer. Amen. So we come to our final hymn this morning as we sing together, Now Thank We All Our God. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted, support the weak, help the afflicted, honour everyone. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.